Dear children, we have revised our first poem, Rain in the Night. Now, let us see this activity-based lesson. Lesson number 7, Be a Writer 1, What Isha Said. In this, I will show you a few pictures. These pictures are in Isha's life, a day in Isha's life. Okay, you have to look at this pictures carefully. Using your imagination, you have to guess what Isha must have said or will say on each occasion. Then write the complete conversation in your notebook. So are you ready for this? So let us begin. Let me show you the first picture. Look at this picture. What can you see? On the left hand side at the top, you can see a clock. What is the time? It's morning time, 6:30. Okay? You can see mother and Isha in the picture. Yes. What do you think there? Hurry up or you'll be late. Who has said this statement? Mother. Now, with the help of your imagination, can you guess what Isha must have said? Yes. Isha must have said, Mummy, can I go back to bed? I am still sleepy. Now, I'll show you the next picture. What can you see in the second picture? On the right hand side, there is a clock. What is the time? 9 o'clock in the morning. And you can see a dialogue. I think you should tell the teacher about it. This statement is given by her friend, Isha's friend. Now, in the picture, can you see Isha is standing with a book and that book is torn. So, what can you guess that Isha must have said? Yes, she must have said, See, someone has torn my book. Dear children, you are doing well. Here is the third picture in front of you. Now, what's the time you think? Can you see in the clock? Yes, 10 o'clock in the morning. Isha is still in the school. And there is, you can see in the picture, Isha's teacher, two boys and Isha raising her hand. What is the statement there? That's not the right answer, Nikhil. So, teacher is saying that the answer given by Nikhil is wrong. And what do you think that Isha is raising hand for? Correct. She's saying, I know the correct answer, teacher. That's really very good. Here is another picture in front of you. This is evening time. And what is the time in the clock? 8 o'clock. Who is there in the picture? Grandmother of Isha and Isha. What they are doing? Yes, they are watching TV. Now, grandmother is asking Isha, why do you like the program so much? What do you think Isha might have replied? I like this program because it is very funny. Dear children, you also like funny programs, right? Yes, because Isha and you are of similar age. So, you all like cartoons, funny movies or funny programs. Isn't it? Great. Now, let us move to our next picture. In this picture, what is the time? 8:30. What do you think they are doing? Yes. It's a dining table and Isha, her mother, her grandmother and father, they are sitting and having their dinner together. There's a dialogue box showing that statement of father. What father is saying? You must eat everything that's on your plate. So, father is teaching Isha that you should eat everything. What do you think now? Isha is replying, Daddy, it is so spicy. Okay, dear children, you should eat spicy food as well as sweet food. Don't only just concentrate or eat only sweet food. Okay, you must balance your food. Okay, now last picture of our video. What can you see in the picture? What is the time? Yes, it is 9:30 at night. Mother is telling Isha to sleep. But there is a conversation of mother and Isha. Mother's statement is, but you have heard that story before, Isha. Now, with this, you can guess that Isha is requesting mummy to tell a story. And the story she has already heard from mother. Children, you also like to hear stories. Yes, you also might have requested your mother to say stories sometime. So, the daily routine of Isha and yours is resembling. Resembling means similar to your routine. Okay, so you could guess the statements or you could imagine what Isha wanted to say on each occasion. Now, you will have to write it in your workbook. In your workbook, page number 23, that conversation which we have discussed, you are just going to write that. Okay, but your question number 2, you have to write it in the short story. These are the points with the help of which you are going to write a short story. Okay, so this homework you will do it in your zero number book, and tomorrow I will send you the answer. Question number 2, you can write directly. Narrating a story, it can be done directly in the workbook. Okay, page number 23 I will send tomorrow in the worksheet. Okay, now today you are going to write rain in the night question answers in your workbook. Okay, and with the help of your workbooks, try to solve 23 page number and 24 page number. You are going to do it on your own. All the instructions, these all instructions are also mentioned in the worksheet provided to you today. Okay, so meet you tomorrow. Bye. Take care.